This video is brought to you by my supporters on Patreon, Buy Me a Coffee, Nas.io, and YouTube. If you wish to support me, you can find the links below. When I was a little kid, I used to take trips like these with my family, and I used to sit in the back of a moving car. I'd look out the window and I'd see the sight, and I'd wonder to myself, why is the moon following me? And you don't even have to be in a car to observe this. You can just be randomly walking somewhere in a park and you'd see exactly this sight. The moon will be moving with you at your pace. No faster, no slower. Why is that? So let's try and answer that question in this video. My name's Pranav, you're watching scienceisdope. Let's begin. I'm gonna try and answer that question in two ways. One with no technicality at all, and one with some basic geometry. But if you watch that second part of the video, I'll give you a reward. See the stars in the night sky? How do we know how far they are from us? Because astronomers will tell you precisely what the distance of a star from us is. How do they know that? Because we can't use a measuring tape or any such device. Obviously, because there's no one at the other end to hold the tape for you, so to speak. So how exactly do you measure the distance of something that's in front of you? Let's try and answer that, starting with no math. See this clip. If you look closely at what's happening, you'll see that the trees and the bushes on the side of the road are moving faster across the frame. But if you look at that house that's a little further away, you'll see that it's moving slower. Slower than the trees, at least. And if you look at that mountain peak that's even further away, you'll see that it's moving even slower. What's the pattern you see? The farther away an object is, the slower it moves across my field of vision. This phenomenon is something known as parallax. You might have seen when you visit certain websites, when you see their web pages, or maybe when you see some smartphone application, or even some wallpapers, or in certain video games that you might have played, you would have noticed that the design is in such a way that it gives the illusion of parallax. They use the same idea of the movement of the foreground and the movement of the background at different rates. And with it, they achieve the illusion of depth of field. Okay, coming back, what's the point I'm trying to make? That the further away an object is, the lesser it moves in our field of view. Now think of how far away the moon actually is. It's really freaking far. So that means it should move very little when we move. And that's exactly what we see. It barely moves in our field of view. It's staying in one spot. So when we move, it looks as if it's moving with us. Because obviously when something or someone is following you, they are in the same spot in your field of view. Okay, that's the basics of this explained. But why does this happen? To understand that, you have to look at some math. Let's assume we're moving on a road from point A to point B. On the side of the road, we see a tree, a house, and a mountain. As we move from A to B, these three points will move the same distance, but in the opposite direction. That is, they move with respect to us from B to A in the opposite direction. Let the average position of our car be somewhere in the middle, say C. Now let's draw a line from the point C, connecting it to A and B for the tree, for the house, and for the mountain. Now for the tree, we notice that this angle is the greatest, and for the mountain, it's the smallest. So what is this angle? It's this: tree, house, mountain. So it's basically the angle you have to turn your head by to keep looking at that object. In other words, it's the angle the object sweeps in your field of view. And clearly, the further away an object is, the smaller the angle will be. Cool. Now I can draw the same angle the other way also, from the points A and B of the car to the tree, to the house, and to the mountain. And you get the same angle, and they get progressively smaller the further away an object is. The reason I drew the same angles this way is because now I can call them the angles subtended by the tree, the house, and the mountain at the points A and B of our field of view. I did this because now I want to make this statement. The angle subtended by the moon is so small that we barely have to turn our heads to keep the moon in our field of view. In fact, the moon is something like 380,000 kilometers away. At that distance, the angle subtended by the moon at the points A and B is so small that even if the points A and B were so far apart that they were at the ends of the earth, the angle would still only be 2 degrees. See this? That is how tiny 2 degrees is, barely perceptible by the human eye. But when we move, anything that's staying in the same spot seems to be moving with us. And that's basically what causes this illusion. But there are many other things like the moon that are extremely far away. Do we see the same illusion with them? Like the sun, maybe? Yes, we do see the same illusion with the sun. But then why isn't this often associated with the sun? Probably because no one stares at the sun long enough to notice this illusion. What about the stars? Yep, exactly the same illusion. But with stars, we can use this exact same idea to learn even more, like how far away they are from us. Let's see how. What exactly is an angle? When you have a circle and two points A and B on the circle, if we draw a radius each to those two points, the angle at the center, aka the angle subtended by those two radii, is a measure of how much the radius has to rotate from the point A to reach the point B. And it's given by theta equals AB by R. For any length AB, this will be true. In fact, this is where we get the relation for pi from. What is pi for a circle? Let me know in the comments if you already know. Now let's draw a line joining A and B. And let's make that angle small. For very small angles, I think it's more than fair to make the approximation that the line AB is equal to the arc AB. And also that the length of the radius, the length R, is equal to the length of the distance between the center and the line AB. Now you have everything you need to measure the distance of something that's in front of you, like a star. Here's what you do. Point your telescope at the star. Now exactly 6 months later, when the Earth is at the opposite end of its orbit, you'll have to turn your telescope again at the star. But this time you'll note the angle that you had to turn the telescope by. This angle is the same as the angle of head turn that you saw in the previous tree example. It's the same angle that the tree subtends on your field view. We are in the exact same scenario with the star. We note this angle that the star subtends on the Earth, that is the angle that you had to turn your telescope by. We note the distance between the points A and B, it's the diameter of Earth's orbit. Remember the relationship we had between the angle and the radius? Here the radius is the distance that we need to calculate. So R equals theta times AB. Simple, isn't it? You just calculated the distance to the star. And this is exactly how astronomers do it. Now you have to remember one thing though. This approximation is only valid for small angles theta. Only then we can approximate the arc AB to be the line AB. Otherwise, the error will be too much. But fortunately for us, even the nearest star to Earth is so far away that this angle theta will always be a small angle. And while we're on this topic, I should also mention something. If this angle theta is 1 second, by the way, 60 seconds make a minute, 60 minutes make a degree of angle. So 1 second is a very, very small angle. Anyway, where was I? If theta is 1 second, the distance R you get is defined as 1 parsec. You might have heard of it. It's a unit used in long distance measuring. It's equal to 3.26 light years. That's how that is defined. And there you have it. You just learned about why the moon follows you and how we measure distance to stars. If you like my content, it'd be really awesome if you could support me, because that becomes my main source of income. You can give me a one-time support using one of these options, or give me continued support using one of these options, for which you will get perks that you see on your screen. One of those perks is a private WhatsApp group that you get to join, where we do stuff like this. One of our members is an astronomer, and so we have amateur astronomy sessions over Zoom call. So if you're interested in things like that, do join. I want to thank my highest tier supporters on Patreon and YouTube. If you support me in my highest tiers, you can get your name displayed on the video like this. If you like this video, you might also like this one, where I spoke about how the moon doesn't actually go around the Earth. I'll see you in the next one. Till then, remember, science is dope.